And I try to develop there this notion of God, personal God, as a necessary illusion, but not in this bad sense of for stupid people and so on. If I may conclude with this to make it a little bit easier, I tell there, maybe you know it, I'm sorry, it was told to me by my good friend Jean-Pierre Dupuy, a certain pseudo-ancient anecdote, it's not clear where is the origin. Niklas Luhmann uses it, Dupuy uses it, okay, one of the subtitles of my book is entitled The 12th Camel, as one of the names of the god, you know. And this is what fascinates, it's a pseudo, I think, it didn't really happen there, it was invented in Europe, I'm not sure, maybe it is from there. The legend, Arab one, goes like this. There was an old merchant who was dying, and he left his legacy to his sons were 11 camels. And he made his will, he says to his sons, elder son, middle, the younger son, that they have to divide his legacy so that the older son gets half of it, the next son gets, I think, one third and then one fourth or whatever of it. But there was a problem, you know, like, what is half of 11? Because the father insisted the division must work exactly, otherwise you get nothing. Okay, the sons ask a wise old guy who said, no problem, I will solve it. He says, I will give you a present, another camel. And then they tell him, but why should you lose a camel? He tells them, don't worry, you will not, I will get it back. Now we have 12 camels, you know, and let's divide it. Half of 12 is 6. The elder guy gets 6 camels. One third of 12 is, 1/3, 1/4 is 3, and the last guy gets 1/6 or whatever of 12, which is 2. So 6, 3, 2. We divided it precisely the way father ordered. Count it. 6 and 3 and 2 is what? 11. And so now I take my camel back. And it worked. And the idea of Dupuy is that this is God. You know, you have to, it's the 12th camel. To make the operation, to make it function, you have to count it in. It's in this way, but not in this derogatory way, we need an illusion to survive. It's more a structural necessity. In that it's not simply we can think without him. It's this wonderful paradox of an illusion, which if you, it's an illusion, but if you erase it, you lose also the reality of which it is the illusion.